Hello everyone, in this video we are going to study carbon nanotubes. What are the learning outcomes of this video? We expect that after watching this video, students will be able to define and explain structure of graphene and carbon nanotube. Explain different orientations and different types of carbon nanotubes, and students will be able to describe different properties and applications of carbon nanotubes. Before going to carbon nanotubes, we must know allotropes. Okay, so what are allotropes? Allotrope, it means certain elements, they are having different forms or they exist in nature in different forms in same physical state. See, here in the same physical state is very important because we know there are three states. The matter exists in three states, solid, liquid and gas. But in one state, for example in solid, the same element has a different structures, so that we call as allotropes. So very famous example of allotrope that we know is the carbon. The different allotropes of carbon are diamond, graphite and fullerene. We know basically diamond is a carbon, graphite is also basically carbon, but there is huge difference in the properties of diamond and graphite, and that is only because different atomic arrangements. We know that diamond is having crystalline structure, it is very hard and it is insulating. On the contrary, graphite is conducting and we know it is brittle in nature. This diamond and graphite, these are the allotropes of carbon. They exist in bulk form. But at nanoscale, again we get the new allotrope of carbon, and that is the fullerene. And that includes nanotubes as well as buckyballs. Now this is the buckyball. It is also called as Buckminster fullerene. Now this buckyball is made up of 60 carbon atoms. And we can see here, these 60 carbon atoms, they are bound together, they are attached in the form of hexagon or pentagon, and it looks like a saucer ball, and therefore the name given is buckyball. There are about 20 hexagons and 12 pentagons, and we can see here these carbon atoms are present at the vertices of this polygon, and see this edge or this side of the polygon is the bond between these carbon atoms. See this buckyball, it has 60 carbon atoms, so, and it is a single molecule, and so we can call it as a macromolecule. Okay, so this is buckyball. Now what is the carbon nanotube? See, in 1991, see, this is the Japanese scientist Sumio Ejima, he discovered carbon nanotubes. So the name suggests it is the tube. So it is made up of carbon, and that carbon, it is in the cylindrical form, and therefore we call it as a carbon tube, and it is at nanoscale, and therefore it is nanotube, carbon nanotube, or in short we call it as CNT. Now before going to CNT, we must know what is graphene. So graphene is one atom thick layer of carbon atoms, and these carbon atoms are interconnected in hexagon. See, this is very important. It is one atom thick layer, only one atom. See, when you take a paper sheet, very thin paper sheet, so even that very thin paper sheet, it consists of number of atomic layers, about millions of atomic layers. And here we are talking about only one layer, single layer of carbon atoms. So obviously Graphene is the lightest material. It is conducting and at the same time it is strongest material. It is even stronger than diamond. It is because the one graphene sheet is the one molecule. It is harder material. At the same time, it is flexible and we can stretch it like rubber. And so we are very much interested in graphene because the hardness and the flexibility, these two properties hardly coexist. In 2004, these two scientists from University of Manchester, Andre Geim and Konstantin Novoselov, these two scientists, they succeeded in synthesis of carbon. So what did they do? They just peeled out the one atomic layer of graphene from graphite strip with the help of adhesive tape. And for this discovery, in 2010, the Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to these two scientists from University of Manchester. Okay, so this is the graphene. So you can see this is the graphene. This is one atom thick layer of carbon. See, these are the carbon atoms we can see here. And we can easily see they are interconnected into hexagons. See, this is the hexagon. This is the covalent bond between the carbon atoms. So all these sides of hexagon, they are nothing but the covalent bond between the carbon atoms. Okay, so this is the graphene. Okay, so again I repeat, the graphene is one atom thick layer of carbon atoms and it is connected into hexagonal rings. And the rolled up sheet of graphene is called carbon nanotube. Now how to roll the graphene sheet? See here, this is the graphene sheet. This is the graphene sheet. Okay, now we can roll it in different ways. To roll means what? We take a sheet and the two sides, we join them together to form a cylinder. So we do the same thing here. Suppose now I roll it in this fashion. I take this side and we attach it to this side. Okay, so we get a cylinder and see, this will be the axis of cylinder. So we get this structure. Is it clear? I will repeat now. See, this side of the graphene sheet, I roll it and join it to this side. So we get a cylinder like this and this becomes the axis of cylinder. So we get this structure and this we call as a armchair. Okay, so carefully observe this armchair structure. You see now how these hexagons are arranged. You can easily see they are parallel to the axis. Now this is the one method. Now another method, now we take this side. We roll it, we take this side and we attach it to this side after rolling. So now this will be the axis of the cylinder and this is the structure of the cylinder. We can see here clearly zigzag line and these are the hexagons. So this type of structure or this type of CNT, we call it as a zigzag. And see, this is the diagonal. And if we roll it in such a fashion that this diagonal becomes the axis, okay, this diagonal becomes the axis, then we call it as a chiral. Okay, so based on orientation, we have seen there are different types of CNTs. This is armchair, this is zigzag, and this is chiral. Okay, now I know to draw the figure of the CNT is very difficult, so I will give you the simple method how to draw it. So first we see armchair. So what is the armchair? How will you describe armchair? So we have seen the hexagons are arranged parallel to the axis of the CNT. So just you draw the hexagons along a certain line. do not try to draw the whole tube, just you draw one line of the hexagon and one more hexagon we draw like this. And now bold this structure we get. So it is like a chair. So you can get the structure like this. It looks like chair, and therefore this structure we call it as armchair. Now next is the Chic Jack. Here the hexagons, they form a circle around the axis of the tube. Okay, so how to draw? Just you draw the hexagon side by side and just highlight this zigzag line. So this structure we call it as a zigzag. And then we have a chiral. So we have seen that in this type of rolling, the nanotube is slightly twisted and we do not get any definite structure or any definite pattern. Now what is the chiral? What is actual meaning of the word chiral? It means asymmetric. The structure is not having any symmetry, and the structure and its mirror image, if they are not superimposable, then we call it as a chiral structure. So we have seen this is the third type of orientation of CNT, and this is the chiral. Now basically we have seen the graphene as a single molecule, and the rolled up sheet of graphene is the CNT. So naturally one carbon nanotube is one molecule, and it is made up of millions of carbon atoms, right? One CNT is one molecule, only one molecule, only single molecule. It is made up of millions of carbon atoms, and naturally it is very strong because it is a single molecule, and so to break it or to break those bonds is very difficult, and hence it is very strong material. And again it is having the hexagonal structure that gives it the very high tensile strength and elastic properties. The diameter of carbon nanotube is few nanometer because we call it as a nanotube. So it is a few nanometer, but its length may be in micrometer or even it can be in centimeter. Okay. So again, there are two types. Means based on orientation, we have seen the three types of CNTs, armchair, zigzag and chiral. And again, we have two types of CNTs. The first one is the single walled nanotube, carbon nanotube. So it is very simple. As the name suggests, it is only one nanotube, and we can say that it is the basic building block of multi-walled nanotube. So this is the single walled carbon nanotube. It is only one tube. There is nothing else. Only one tube. It is just the one sheet of graphene, and we roll it, that we call as a single walled. Then another type is the multi-walled, naturally MWCNT, and naturally we can define it like it is made up of number of concentric tubes. Now one multi-walled carbon nanotube, it may contain about 2 to 50 coaxial tubes. This concentric or coaxial means all those tubes are having common access, one inside the other, and therefore we call them as the concentric tubes or coaxial tubes. Now see, this is the first tube, this is the second. So the distance between these two tubes, successive tubes or neighboring tubes, it varies from 0.34 nanometer to 0.36 nanometer. Okay, so this is the multi-walled carbon nanotube. Okay, so we have seen what is graphene, then we have seen what is the carbon nanotube, that rolled up sheet of graphene is the carbon nanotube. And based on orientation, there are three types, and the two types of carbon nanotube, single walled and multi walled nanotube. Okay friends, so in the next video we shall discuss different properties and applications of carbon nanotubes. Thank you very much.